As part of the Environment Agency's Digital Asset Data and Information Programme, we are developing the business case and purpose of a smart object library. Smart objects are graphical representations of frequently used asset types that have integrated data attributes. These then enable digital design processes, which enhance our future efficiency. Having smart objects will enable the rapid graphical representation of assets. This, in turn, will enable Environment Agency teams to benefit from the various internal and external uses that such models enable, including visualizations to share with third parties and information on scale and footprint. Assigning these models data attributes that are in accordance with the Environment Agency's Data Requirements Library provides common addressing that helps data to flow between different information sources. These attributes represent key properties of assets that are useful across these different data sources, which enables us to optimize our time and to automate basic activities. In order to demonstrate the capabilities of smart objects, we have developed some prototypes. These help us to prove the capabilities, to learn lessons for future development, and to demonstrate the value that provides a business justification for wider development. We've developed these in the three standard modelling packages that the Environment Agency and its suppliers have confirmed they use. This helps us to explore tools that can cover the project lifecycle. Smart objects are templates for commonly used assets that allow the development of 3D models of new or existing assets with relative ease and minimal data input. Where possible, the smart objects are built with typical geometry of the relevant type of asset. However, the capabilities of the software enable so much more. This typical geometry is underlain by parametric logic, which means that the physical size and shape of the objects react to certain key parameters. In this case, the base width, required excavation, and thickness of a flood defence wall are all reacting to the level of floodwater above the ground surface, giving more accurate indication of material needs, footprint, and impact of a proposed structure. This smart operation does not, though, limit the need for close control by designers when developing new assets. They will need to modify the parametric relationships to suit local conditions, and they will also need to look in detail at the output information to check that it is logical and sensible. It is ultimately the designers that take the responsibility for the assets being suitable. As the model is built from the smart object, information about the asset is developed as a property of the model. That information includes constituent material quantities and geolocation data. All of this can be used as direct output. The attributes required by the Data Requirements Library are also built into the non-graphical information within the smart objects. Some of those attributes are smartly completed as the model object is built. Other attributes respond to further input. Non-graphical information from the smart objects can be exchanged using the exchange formats defined in the Environment Agency's Employers Information Requirements in order to facilitate the fastest sharing between the different data stores. These include geolocational information. Our prototype development has helped us to understand the necessity and capabilities of the three different software packages and the important features required for specification and procurement of smart objects. The objects are made smart by both their geometric capabilities, which enable rapid development of models, and also the data that is attributed to them. Ensuring that this data meets the standard requirements of the Environment Agency means that the effective and automatic sharing of information across data stores is enabled. Smart objects therefore help us to meet current needs in a number of ways, but primarily through developing high-quality graphical models and providing effective data conduits. This is not the end of the story, though, as this type of data sharing is the necessary foundation on which we can build our stronger future capabilities. Capabilities that allow us to know more about our assets and, specifically, to face our carbon challenges and to make sure that we are using resources efficiently as well as effectively.